Good morning, everybody. This is Dr. Rakesh Gupta from Indore, and we are starting today's proceedings with the very important session, that is the award posters presentation. And why this session is extremely important, because the participants in this session, they get encouragement because it's an award session. So it's an important session, and good morning, Dr. Sanjeev Mishra.
Yeah, good morning, sir.
I request Dr. Anup Purandare to present his paper, and your time is 7 minutes and 2 minutes for question and answer. So kindly restrict to your timings.
Yes, sir. Sir, please. I have a center recorded session actually. They are playing it.
Okay, go ahead.
Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Anup Purandare from Sion Hospital, Mumbai, and I am going to present a case series of spinal arachnoid cysts. Spinal arachnoid cysts are intraspinal, extramedullary, or intramedullary loculated CSF collections, which are composed of normal or slightly thickened arachnoid membrane. These are either acquired or are idiopathic. Males have a slightly higher predilection than females. Thoracic spine is the most commonly involved, along with lumbar, sacral, and cervical is the least common involved. Symptoms vary from pain, weakness, and radiculopathy. Rupture is a very rare complication. Causes can be divided into primary and secondary. Primary is most commonly idiopathic, and secondary are arachnoid adhesions which develop secondary to inflammation due to infection, hemorrhage, or iatrogenic causes, such as injected contrast media or from the intraoperative contaminants of the fibrin glue. Some cysts are due to trauma from lumbar puncture, anesthetic procedures, or any intradural surgery. Pathophysiology of a primary cyst is fast systolic CSF velocities in the dorsal space result in dissection within the septum postigmatum. Most investigators nowadays prefer the passive fluid therapy for enlargement of the cyst. In early stages, pulsatile CSF dynamics may promote cyst enlargement. An osmotic gradient can then facilitate further expansion. Naber was first to classify this kind of cyst. According to his classification, type 1 is an extradural meningeal cyst without spinal nerve root fibers. Type 2 is an extradural meningeal cyst with spinal nerve root fibers, which are usually called the Tarlow cyst. And type 3 are the spinal intradural arachnoid cyst. Type 1 is subdivided into extradural meningeal arachnoid cysts and type 1b into sacral meningocele. Coming to the imaging, MRI is ideally preferred for this kind of cyst. MRI differentiates extramedullary from the intramedullary cyst, along with it shows the displacement of the cord and the nerve roots. It also shows the mass effect and the myelomalacia. Myelography shows filling defect in the intradural arachnoid cyst and effacement of the subarachnoid space in the extradural arachnoid cyst. In our series of 13 patients, we have operated 7 patients were extradural / subdural, and 6 patients were intramedullary. Presentation varied from weakness, paresis, or paralysis, along with backache and tingling numbness. This is a patient of D10L1 extradural cyst, a C3C4 subdural cyst, a D10L3 extradural cyst, a sacral extradural cyst, a D11L1 extradural cyst. This is a pontomedullary and cervical intramedullary arachnoid cyst. This patient was operated twice and was referred to us for further management. A dorsolumbar intramedullary cyst, a lumbosacral intramedullary cyst. Near complete to complete recovery in all 13 patients of extradural / intramedullary arachnoid cyst was achieved postoperatively. out of 13 patients, 3 patients had recurrence. First patient developed after 5 years. The second one developed after 8 years. And the third was operated twice in a private setting and had come with the recurrence of that cyst. All the patients underwent resurgery, and till date, no recurrence has been noted on follow-up. This is a review of literature of spinal intramedullary arachnoid cyst. Spinal intramedullary arachnoid cyst are very rare in nature. Very less cases of this kind of cyst are present in literature at present. Surgical principles of intramedullary cyst. Intramedullary cysts are removed with a dorsomedian or a dorsal root entry zone myelotomy with wide decompression of the cyst and removal of the cyst wall as much as possible. The other treatment option is wide fenestration of the cyst with or without shunting of the subarachnoid space. Separation of the cyst was not done if it was very difficult to separate. Cyst not connected with the subarachnoid space, such as extradural cyst, cyst wall was removed. Extraspinal oblique intravenous cysts were removed through an enlarged intervertebral foramen. Coming to our conclusion, intramedullary arachnoid cysts have been rarely described in the literature so far. This should be kept in mind while considering the differential diagnosis for extramedullary oblique intramedullary cystic lesions. A particular consideration deserves its occurrence in the asymptomatic patients who should be adequately informed on the possible natural evolution. When symptomatic, surgical therapy should be promptly offered, considering that a post-operative complete recovery is usually observed, regardless of the surgical technique. Thank you very much. These are my references.
In what you have done, you have described surgical principles.
Yes.
But what you have done in your series of 13 patients, that is question number one.
Yes.
Question number two, can you tell us something that which cyst will give the motor symptoms, which cyst will give the sensory symptoms? I mean, is there any differentiation the dorsal cyst and ventral cyst?
Yes, sir. Dorsal cyst, most commonly dorsal cyst is a may give rise to sensory symptoms more, and ventral cyst may give rise to motor symptoms. And this is the surgical principles recommended all over, so we have followed the same surgical principles while operating this 13 patients, sir.
Sometimes this cyst may be an incidental finding.
Yes, sir.
So, have you seen only 13 patients or 13 operated patients?
Sir,
how you will decide
these
patients require surgical intervention?
Yes, sir. Sir, these are the 13 operated patients. Okay. We have observed many more which are incidental finding. Sir, I have mentioned in my conclusion that we have explained such patients, if the symptoms occur, surgery is quite helpful. And we have explained the patients regarding this, and surgical outcome is quite good, but only if the symptoms occur.
Okay, so if there is a patient who has some symptoms, not may not be directly related, some vague symptoms, and you find a cyst,
yes.
So what will you do to confirm that these symptoms are related to cyst?
Sir, firstly, I'll confirm the position of the cyst. Secondly, the nature, whether the location of the cyst, then I'll correlate to his symptoms. If it is correlating to his symptoms, then only we'll give a operative indication for this patient. Otherwise, I'll manage the patient conservatively. Because if the patients are correlating with his level of spine, then removing the fenestration or even a removing of a cyst wall may drastically improve the future prognosis of the patient, sir.
I have a question.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, in MRI, how do you differentiate between a syringomyelia and intramedullary cyst?
Sir, syringomyelia usually sir, on we usually differentiate on the involvement of the arachnoid on the histopathology basically, and arachnoid cyst have a arachnoid wall and syringomyelia contains ependymal cells on the wall, sir.
No, radiologically, we are going for histology. Can you predict from the imaging that it is a syringomyelia or intramedullary arachnoid cyst?
Sir, it is quite difficult to differentiate, but sir, go ahead with the CSF flow studies. CSF flow studies can help with the CSF flow studies can help us differentiate, such as arachnoid cyst is hypointense on T1 and hyperintense on T2.
Okay, that's all. Then next thing, will you, what are other differential diagnoses of intramedullary arachnoid cyst?
There may be neurentric cyst. Secondly, there can be a syringomyelia, as you said. And thirdly, intramedullary cystic tumors can also, give a differential of arachnoid cyst.
Yeah. Thank you.